Alright, baby. Up next we got what the book. Up next we got in the Bible. Excuse my French. We got in the Bible. Yo, what Kyle, what do you think this song is gonna be about? Just predictions.
I feel like it might be a gospel.
Gospel? You think it's gonna be singing or rapping? Gospel.
Like, I think it's gonna be singing.
Singing? Alright.
Yeah. Sound like some Kanye shit.
In the Bible, Lil Durk and Giveon, I think it says.
Lil Durk's in it, so let's hear it.
Okay. Count on my body, damn the things just start to pile. Judge me how you judge me, take them bitches out of trial. Fuck 100 niggas, how them niggas love you now.
And by the way, Kai, I do also, like, I don't, so with the reaction, because I'm also posting this on YouTube, so I have to take the break and kind of give my own take on it, my own review, so that way it's, you know, my own reaction to.
No, do your thing, bro. You got to. I'm just here to listen.
Yeah, because I know you're here to listen. I also do want you to hear it straight through, you know, so I kind of feel like it's unfair, but I appreciate you being here reacting with me, bro.
Of course, bro.
Thank you.
You don't know love, you don't love me like my child. Lay your ass down and that liquor get you fired up. Turn up every day, girl, it don't say that in the Bible. Can't give it up cause you love the lifestyle.
Can't give it up cause you love that lifestyle. That goes in many ways, I think. There's could you give an example to that? I think there's many examples. But
that lyric?
Yeah, to that lyric. Can't give it up because you love that lifestyle. Like, what's one job that a woman can't give up or a guy can't give up because they love that lifestyle, quote unquote?
I mean, for guys, I feel like it'd be a lot, like, for the streets. For example, like, Lil Durk being in this song, like, that makes sense. You know, like, he's not going to change for his bitch because he's living a certain lifestyle that he lives. You know what I'm saying? If, you know.
Okay.
He know he can get another bitch.
Yeah.
So, but for Drake, you know, that nigga fucks with a lot of different women and all that other shit. So, I mean, I guess it all depends. But for women, I feel like if it was a woman, like, doing stripping or something, like, she's not going to get, like, Cardi B, for example.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Was she going to give up her lifestyle for niggas? Fuck no.
Probably not. All right. As you should. Do your thing.
Told the girls to meet at town. Now y'all doing shots. Now them bitches got you fired up. Don't know who you talking about. I'll put that on the Bible. Turning up on me.
Hey, okay. You heard that?
Yeah.
Don't know what you talking about. I put it on the Bible. I like that. That boy talking that nasty.
You made me turn it back around. And you know, think I'm tied to woods the way I'm teed off the 17. And you know, pop this on whatever jeans, forever green. And you know, told me a lot of things, but ain't say everything. But now I know every single thing. There was plenty things I didn't know. Plenty things you didn't say. Was fucking with you anyway. Was fucking with you way before you had some confessions to make.
Hey, I ain't gonna lie, my boy, I think all these tracks right here are actually gonna fit this title, Certified Lover Boy. I thought he would throw some little rap here and there, but I honestly think he got every single person in the industry to just sing some lovey-dovey shit, bro. Honestly, that's just my take on it.
I don't know about 21 Savage. I don't think that one's gonna be lovey-dovey, maybe.
Nah, you don't think? Hey, let's get there. I like it. Even Jay-Z, he probably got Jay-Z talking that ish about the baby mama and stuff. Like, yeah.
You decide to take it to the
grave. You know damn well Beyonce fucking that nigga in that song.
Hey, yeah, baby, come on, get us up. I need her to be super realistic.
Hey, I know you gonna take it. Ain't no. Okay. Count on my body, damn the things just start to pile. Judge me how you judge me, take them bitches out the trial. Fuck 100 niggas, how them niggas love you now.
Okay, we gonna actually bring that back, cause he actually said a lot there. We gonna bring that back real quick.
Things just start to pile. Judge me how you judge me. Count on my body, damn the things just start to pile.
Counting on my body. Damn, them things just start to pile. Okay, so getting with a lot of women, right? Okay, you know, eventually, you know what happens. You Damn, that's a lot. You know, that's a lot.
Judge me how you judge me. Take them bitches out of trial.
Judge me how you judge me. Take them bitches out of trial. Fire, bro. Judge me how you judge me. Judge me how you judge me. A lot of times, it's also... See, like, when you with somebody, it's both people's fault. You know, you shouldn't have created so much space between you guys because then, you know?
Yeah.
Judge me. Niggas, how them niggas love you now?
But... On the opposite side, you know, fuck 100 dudes. How them dudes love you now? They probably always gonna want to come back and shit like that. Cool, but they don't really love you, man. They just want to, you know what I'm saying, one time or two or 10 times or how many other times you love them. But they don't love you, baby. They don't love you.
You don't know love. You don't love me like my child. Lay your ass down and that liquor get you fired up.
You don't love me like my child. Man, that was dope as shit. That was a dope bar. He said, you don't love me like my child. What? What a way to measure love, man. That's a dope way to measure love. Dope as shit.
Turn up every day, girl. It don't say that in the Bible. Can't give it up because you love the lifestyle.
Okay, 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 trenches, bitch. I got her salon. Gucci, Pucci, deep in the budget. She hit on the Virgin for Louis Vuitton. She's not in the Bible, the wife. I'm Muslim, I go back around. I'm smiling and holding my gun.
Hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. My man just hummed while rapping. Hold up. That was fire.
Louis Vuitton. She's not in the Bible, the wife. Voice of the street.
I'm Muslim, I go back
around. Hold on, hold on.
Can't give it up because you love the lifestyle.
Okay, 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 trenches, bitch, I got her salon. Gucci and Pucci is deep in the budget. She hit on the Virgin for Louis Vuitton. She's not in the Bible, the wife, I'm Muslim, I'm the Quran. The way I be smiling and holding my gun. She think I be mimicking Vaughn, grandson. She only play.
Yo, RP Vaughn, bro. Real shit, anytime. Bro.
Gone too soon. Talent gone too soon.
My man, bro. Bro, where there's Vaughn and where there's fucking Pop Smoke, bro. Oh my God, bro. Oh my God, bro. Chills, bro. Yo, chills on. Bro, I'm getting goosebumps, bro. Bro, these two dudes, bro. Bro, man. Different. Different, bro. Those two. Bro, kids, bro, fucking young ass.
Play me in the whip.
RIP, man, to the both of them. Juice WRLD is another nasty beast of a fucking animal with the words. We actually got to listen to, like, not today, because we actually got to do all of this stuff. But you said Juice WRLD is coming out with an album?
It's going to, so the whole thing is, it's called The Party Never Ends, and it's going to be a three-part album. There's going to be three parts of the album, bro. Like, that's how crazy shit is. Because he has so many songs that, you know, he freestyled most of his songs off his albums.
Yeah, I ain't going to lie to you, bro. Not a lot of people going to believe me, bro. But I also freestyled a lot of the songs that I also have made. But
I believe you. Shit.
I appreciate that. But because that's just a dope way to create. But obviously, I'm not saying that I'm as good as Juice WRLD or anything like that. It's just a dope way to create music when you have the talent to be able to, like, listen to a beat and freestyle. Now, what Juice WRLD has or had, damn, bro, I can't even. That sucks to say, bro. Just changing the S with the D, just has or had. Like, what Juice WRLD has is just, bro, when he spits some shit, it's just some shit that it was just like, what?
Off the dome, man. It's like he actually just said that with that. And
what? Like, bro, Juice WRLD, bro. We got to watch a documentary. We got to react to something really, really, really memorable for Juice WRLD. We really gotta got to do that on the channel, bro.
We'll watch a freestyle that he did on Eminem beats for an hour.
Yeah, that'd be dope as shit. I would love to react to some shit like that, bro.
You would love the shit that he says, actually. Like,
yeah, we'll yeah, bro. For real. For sure. We should actually get together tomorrow to do that, bro.
Dude, I'm fucking down. I'm always down to listen to that nigga. Because even Eminem said, bro, he's like, for such a young age, we tried to do that back in the day at the shop, at the workshop where he would, you know, freestyle all the time. Like,
yeah,
that's hard to fucking do. An hour just spitting rhymes?
Yeah.
Shut the fuck up.
No, that is... What? That's wicked as fuck. I could barely spit for like 10 minutes. I could time it. All right, what else I got to say? Start throwing me words, King Lowe's. Back to the song, brother. Let's get it. I'm just promoting my bitch. Drake's song, do a being stream for show. I'm just promoting her shit. Nasty with it. Take her to Soul No Bellow and get her some nasty titties. Fashion nigga. Okay. Rule call when they drop like send my addy with it. Bitch left me and I'm glad she did it. No, I be testing, bitch. Back to back, I'm rasping with him. Lean voice, I'm raspy with it. That was that sexy talk shit. Raspy was, I'm nasty with it. I love what he said here. My bitch left, I'm glad she did it. Sometimes, I'm being honest, you know, sometimes it's a dope thing that they decide that that's what they want to do because it helps everybody in the situation. It's it's a good choice, honestly, like, especially after you hurt somebody so long. When they build the strength up to be like, you know what, I'm out of here. It's just, you know, it's dope. It's bittersweet. I've been using that word lately because, you know, it's true. You know,
It is true, bro.
It's bittersweet because, you know, it's cool that they're happy. You want to see the best for them, but it sucks because you're not the person there providing that or being a part of that journey with them. So it sucks. I did my dance one time on TikTok and went viral with it. I fuck with the hum. That hum is fire. I ain't gonna lie. He could probably make that something like in his music, you know, moving forward. He could probably kind of like a tag almost. You could just like in the beginning of a song, just start humming and shit like that. That'd be dope as shit.
That's why that man is called the voice of relationships and the streets.
That's what they call him?
I mean, he said that in the song. He said voice of the streets and relationships. He said that in one of his songs and one of his albums. It was like, that nigga's low-key right.
Fire.
Okay, okay.
Here he comes. Okay, okay.
Down on my body. Damn, the things just start to pile. Judge me how you judge me. Take them bitches out of trial. Fuck, honey.
We've been spending time, but I'm scared. Okay. A good girl inside. But you're tainted every time that I'm there. Here we are now, and it's crazy. Have my flaws down to you, baby. You love. You trust.
Fire. I'm assuming that's Javon, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
what'd you think about that part? I think it was dope. I think his voice was dope as shit.
That's some definitely like slow motion type.
My boy got a little slow. Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
my man Javon made my boy Kai sing to you guys. I hope you guys appreciate that. Clap it up for my man Kai. Y'all heard that? Yeah. Slow motion. Okay, Kai, I might have to put you on the track. I like that.
Slow motion.
Okay, sing that shit, baby.
That's how it feels.
Gotcha. It is how it feels, though.
Don't be proud of me. I'm not what you feel. And you gon' see it real soon. I'm not what you think. Don't be proud of me.
Oof. I love shit like this, bro, because it's vulnerability. This is what he's just being vulnerable, just expressing himself and just being honest about himself and just kind of peeling little layers off. I fuck with shit like that because it's just growth in the person. It takes a lot, bro. I'm telling you to make a song like that, bro. It does.
I'm not what you feel. And when you see the real, will you still want me?
Ooh.
I love that switch up.
If you see the real, will you switch up on me?
Oh, is that what he says? I didn't even pay attention to it. Let me see.
Go back to it. I think he did.
I'm not what you feel. And when you see the real, will you still want me?
Oh. If you see the real, will you still want me?
Ooh, oh, yeah. He did say that.
Yeah.
Oh. Probably like, not. Probably not, to be honest.
Nah, it's like if I try to open myself and I try to show you the real me, will you stay with me? Will you keep it 100?
Mm-hmm. Probably not, man.
Most women know.
Yeah, most women know. But a real one, hell the fuck yeah. Come on, baby. A real one would say, why don't you tell me sooner? Oof.
I've already told people. I've chills. Told, like, my mom and shit. Like, I need a Bonnie and Clyde type.
That's right. Always. You need your Harley Quinn. Harley Quinn for sure.
Harley Quinn and Joker, yeah.
Yo, that's fire. That relationship is so dope. It's sickening, you know, obviously, but it's just dope as fuck to, you know, just think about, because you know there's people out there that do live that way.
That's
real shit, bro. I've seen some couples out there in the world, bro. Yeah, bro. It's dope as shit, man.
Oh, yeah.
It's dope as shit. I think that's it, man. Rest is beat. My boy Drake is back to his... back in the take care days.
This nigga Drake got nudes for fucking years.
One time, give it up one time. You say he got nudes for years?
Yeah, from on like Instagram probably. People.
They were. Yeah, that boy probably getting mad twatty pics. Word up, mad booty hole shots. Hey, do you like this brown eye? Yo, shout out to Kai, bro. Appreciate you, man, for being here for this one. What was the name of this one? In the Bible.
The Bible, yeah.
In the Bible. What do we rate this one? What do we rate this one?
I actually really like that one. I'm going to give it an 8. A solid 8? 8. It's something I definitely would listen to.
Okay. There was actually nothing bad about it. I'm going to give it a high 7. I'm going to give it a high 7. I'm just waiting for just like some fire sexy rap shit. That's what I want. Just some fire sexy rap, talking that nasty talk, like Lights Please kind of song. Like, yeah. You know, like, yo, come on, bro. Come on.
Now, man. I think the reason I give it an 8 is because I really fucked with Durk's part, but I don't think it contributed. Like, he said nothing about the Bible. He said nothing contributing to the Bible or the sins, and which nothing wrong with that. His verse was still fucking fire. It's just I look for the title of the song. What you know what I'm saying?
Okay. Like, okay. So you look for the title of the song to also reflect what is being said in the actual song.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. That's interesting, because sometimes, like, as a you know, song creator, I go and sometimes it's almost like a random name or something I say in the song one or two times, but it doesn't necessarily like, I want to do a better job. What I'm trying to say is I want to do a better job at, like, if I name the song Me and Her, actually make the whole song about me and her, you know, like, you know, not just, yeah.
I just want, like, well, I look into music, I just like, what's the first thing you're going to see and hear? Like, you're not going to hear the song first, but you're going to see the title of the song, and you're going to want to know, okay, it's going to relate to this and this and that. You know, but if you have a song title that doesn't relate to anything you're fucking talking about, that's not really a song title that you should be using, you know what I'm saying?
You're right.
Unless it's referencing something. Otherwise, it's just a cool-ass title, and you just wanted to put it on the title.
You're right.
That's not, you know?
Okay. Well, appreciate you guys. Appreciate you, Kai. As always, we're going to get on to the next one, guys. Guys, rate the song, obviously. Rate it 1 through 10, whatever it is. Comment down below. And we're going to get on to the next one. The next one is Love All with Jay-Z, man. So stay tuned for that one. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. As always, lend a helping hand. 2 hands is better than 1. 3 is always going to be better than that. Stay safe out there, man. And I'm going to catch you guys on the next video.